Hello, if by any chance this guy looks familiar to you, dial 1-900-HANEY-BLOCK is back. I actually like that introduction. It feels like I'm, you know, one of those like at you get when it's like really late at night and these two lesbians would be making it. And then like they'll be like, dial 1-900, fuck my ass if you want to. And you know, I'd be like, what the fuck is this thing? Like, wow, do people actually really dial their numbers? Or do they get their rocks off by, you know, just talking to these hotlines? Oh, could you say that again? Oh yeah. Oh, I don't know, it sounds a little bit ridiculous for me. Well, it might work for some people, you never know these days. Like, some people might like it. They like, ooh. Yeah, I'm back, and I miss you guys. Which is actually really bullshit, because I just miss talking to myself into my camera, in front of my computer, in my room. Sounds a little bit psycho there, but... sounds a little bit psychotic there, but it's true. That's how I make my vlog. I sit in front of my computer, in front of my camera, and talk to my camera. Aw, I miss you, camera. So yeah, at least I'm back. And to all of to those of you who are viewing me right now, I do miss you dearly. And I was just busy over a lot of things, and I'm back, and I'm still busy. Don't worry, it's just. Yeah, it just punches me in the face every time, this thing called busyness, not business. But yeah, I came back from a film today, and it was such a good film because it's Pocri. I've always wanted to pronounce the R in French, but I never could. It's Pocri, alright, it's just Paris 36. It's about some theater shut down in 1936. By some dudes ruling them. I think it was Germans, or I don't know, it's just a little bit... I don't really know history, okay, but yeah, some guy shut it down and they're trying to revive it back. It was such a good movie, I cried twice watching that movie. But the better thing was I went with Ellie, see? Jen and Alex, finally they're back! During this holiday, I missed them because Alex was in Seattle. And a lot more. Ellie was doing the world trip, Europe, and all these other places. Z was gone for a little while to America, but he was kind of busy with himself as well. Jen, on the other hand, was playing games with the whole, how do you call them again? Role-playing games with her posses. And I was a little bit busy as well doing the whole Metaview shit. But yeah, I do miss them, and it's nice to catch up with your best friends. And I was trying to look for any trailer of Pacri 36, but I'm not really sure whether I'll find any or not. But if I do, I'm going to ask you to check it out now.
In this town, the theater brought the people to life.
Vous allez voir, c'est formidable! Allez, rentrez!
Until one day...
Le chansonnier est à moi.
Fate brought the curtain down. Now, with the country torn apart.
Fascista!
And a people struggling to hold on.
N'est plus capable d'élever cet enfant, c'est évident.
They will have to find the voice that could bring it all back.
Suivant.
C'est la jeune fille envoyée par Monsieur Galapia. Est-ce que vous pourriez nous montrer vos jambes, s'il vous plaît?
Oui, quand même.
On vous engage.
Je sais pourquoi vous jouez dur avec moi. Parce que je vous plais.
Ah oui, vous me plaisez.
Et ça, vous pouvez pas le supporter.
Il y en a qui rêvent du Père Lachaise avec un marbre des lettres d'or. Et pour faire bien dans le décor, deux anges qui se disent des fadaises.
It was a very good movie. I normally don't really like, I do like foreign movies, but I don't like boring ones. But this movie was just really, it was so good. It was very theatrical. It's about theater, your passion for theaters. It reminds me of something. It reminds me of how I'm going through my life at the moment. I'm doing Med Review, directing it, so the fact that I'm directing it means I have to pro bono-ly give a lot of my time voluntarily to this thing called Med Review. which is fun. I actually chose to do it. But it, on the other hand, it makes me broke. Like the guys in the movie, most of them were not employed because of this theater. Your passion for theater is such a commitment that you don't really work anymore and you go really broke. So if you guys think actors are rich, think again. It's only Paris Hilton who's rich, okay? In that Tinseltown there. But apart from that, actors are not rich and directors are worse. They live in rags and they have so much passion for these things, so they do anything, you know? So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm fucking broke. Speaking of MedReview, we had a first theme script meeting. It was very internal. Even though some people showed up, I didn't mind. I'm not gonna say anything, I didn't mind. But yeah, it was a great hangout. It was supposed to be a script meeting. It was really good for the first few hours, but then BAM! Alcohol hit. Not because of alcohol, but then YouTube hits the roof and a lot of dance music hits the roof. We just started dancing and having fun, but it was so good. It was one of these social hangouts that spontaneously happened from a script meeting. And we did have a lot of, it was productive, but we did get a lot of stuff done on that night. But me, as usual, having a camera, and the fact that I knew my Vblog was going to be back, I had to do a little bit of a round just to show you what happened or what it was all about.